It's going down. All praise to Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, which is the name of the Father and Son, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus. His name is Yahweh Shai. We are here to prophesy the downfall of this goddamn sinful-ass nation, America. Okay, and I'd like to give double honors to our elders of Great Millstone, the apostles of GMS, who the Most High, who the Lord started to kick, used to kickstart this, who planted that seed to get this going. Well, anyway, we out here to prophesy the downfall of this wicked-ass kingdom, this kingdom where the Israelites are serving, you know, captivity. And we're not supposed to be living here making goddamn rap albums or laboring to get rich. And I think that's an Ecclesiastes. Let's see if I can find one. Because that's what these fools love to do. They love paper chase. They paper chasing. You know, and the Lord is the least thing on their mind. So what the scripture says, when I find it, I got sand in that grass. Well, first I'm gonna get this right here, Ecclesiastes 7 and 12. For wisdom is a defense, and money is a defense. But the excellency of knowledge is that wisdom giveth life to them that have it. Read it again. For wisdom is a defense, and money is a defense. That don't mean make money your fucking priority, right? You know, like these motherfuckers doing, money is their priority. So anybody that all they have on their mind is money, that's a wicked motherfucker. He ain't got no good. He has no good intentions. And that's all he's doing is trying to chase that cheddar. You know, when this place is going to be fucking destroyed, what's the point of trying to build up money? Trying to stack your shit up. What's the point? But that's a wicked man. Where the hell is it at? Look shit up, so be patient and wait for it till we find it. You ain't got nothing better to do. Whoever's watching this, I just found some people. I just found out a couple people that I know actually watch our videos that I didn't even know. I never told them about the video because I already marked them. You know what I'm saying? I mean, they just told me this 2 days ago. Like, well, what is up before? Here's one, Ecclesiastes 10 and 6. Get that one real quick, so I can find this other one.
Is it Ecclesiastes?
Yeah, Ecclesiastes 10 and 6.
10.
We used to go over them rich scriptures all the time. Now, as far as I can't find them. There's one specific one I'm looking for. Because, you know, like the scriptures is giving reference to, wherever your heart is, hey, that's where your mind, you know, that's where your mind is, you know? Wherever your heart, whatever your heart is chasing after, if you ain't chasing after this word, if you ain't doing the Lord's work, I mean, the Lord's going to provide for you anyway. But like I said, if you ain't doing the Lord's work, hey, you into something else, you know? So wherever your heart is, which is your mind, that's what he's going to bless you with, you know? So these people, they chasing after riches, and they're asking the Lord to bless them with riches, so that's what the Lord's going to give them. So when the day of destruction comes, so the Lord already gave, hey, the Lord already provided what you wanted, what you needed. He already gave it to you. You asked for those riches. You're chasing after those riches.
Ecclesiastes 10 and 6. Folly is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in low place.
That's it right there. That's one right there. Folly is set in great dignity, and rich sit in low places. Because, you know, rich sit in low places, low morals. These people do anything possible to get riches, anything, man. Sell their soul, you know, become a big time faggot, you know, or just being a wicked ass nigga, kill your brother, kill your sister, rob your mom, rob your dad, rob any motherfucking body. You know? And morals. What did it say again? What did it say again?
Folly is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in low place.
Folly is set in great dignity. That's a great word right there itself. Folly. Folly. Let me look it up. Some other shit, man. You shouldn't have nothing in common with these people that are on some other shit.
Okay. This is Proverbs 23:3. Be not desirous of his, 4. Labor not to be rich.
That's what I was looking for. Where's it at? 23:4. Okay.
Labor not to be rich. Seize from thy own wisdom. But thou set thine eyes upon that which is not, for riches certainly make themselves wings, they fly away as an eagle toward heaven.
Okay, here's the definition of folly. I'm gonna go back to that though. Okay, mental weakness. Wow. There you go. Mental weakness, because the commandment is to follow the Lord and do what the Lord says, follow his commandments. Not chase money. Ain't no commandments in the Bible where it says chase money. You know, nor make this bullshit rap music. Mental weakness, foolish behavior or character. Now, I wish I could put the video up right now that you can, you know what I'm saying? Because it speaks for itself. The videos with these motherfuckers making rap music, it speaks for itself. Is that even on this thing? Mental weakness, foolish behavior or character. Unwise conduct. What? Unwise, that's unwise conduct, making bullshit videos. Cut them. And what's the other one? Cut them and
100.
Yeah, y'all.
Like the fuck.
Woo!
Them nigga songs.
That's all it is. That's what it sound like. Them niggas hear that shit from the world, they come back and vomit that shit on videos. And try and use the Lord's name. And, you know, putting the Lord's name on that shit.
Dude look retarded with the little knife, little sword. He was going like
oh
this.
Oh my goodness. Like about, like, oh my. You know what? Who that sorry
is? Man. Like he almost hit the dude and everything. Kind of fake ass sword.
Yeah, right. That's really fitting in. Fitting in here. You know? They fitting in the red. You know, anybody making bullshit videos like that. Mental weakness, foolish behavior or character, unwise conduct. In Middle English, like, just like I thought, English, including wickedness, lewdness, madness. I can't wait to make a video. We gotta get together and hook up and make a video just going through that video, dissecting their words, you know? Cause ain't nothing wise. You didn't hear nothing wise come out of it, did you? Cause I watched it a couple times. That's why I regret doing it, cause it's stuck in my head. I was looking for something wise that was coming out of that shit, man. Oh, some fucking fools, man. Some fucking buffoons. Right, oh, that's OGs.
Old dude, jumping in the air and shit.
Right.
Background.
You're right, didn't make no sense. Foolish, man. Like I said, lewdness, madness, cause that's madness. What was he doing anyway? Dancing like a hand mic. From old French, folly, madness, stupidity. They in that spirit of the woman. They in that spirit of the Israelite woman. You know, the Israelite woman is into partying and everything is about fun and partying and her own lustful needs. You know what? I'm gonna think about it real quick. I think it's Ecclesiastes. She that liveth in pleasures, dead while she liveth.
He was on the subway or the train or doing dancing.
They getting around. You know, they getting around, man. They got money to travel and socialize and make new two-third friends. When they all going to, when it really settled, when the dust all settled, they gonna turn against each other anyway. You know, that's going, wicked man can't trust another wicked motherfucker. To the cut. Man, after seeing that shit, man, you gotta take appreciation in real brothers, boy. You know? Because, you know, we can easily be doing stupid shit, you know? Leading each other or fucking astray, man. They ain't good for my spirit, bro. It ain't good for my motherfucking spirit.
How long did that take?
It ain't take long at all. Actually, we didn't notice you was gone but 5 minutes,
bro. Oh, man. I'm worn out. You had to speed walk.
He was running.
No, I didn't run. I was speed walking.
Right.
I'm all dizzy and shit.
You know what that scripture is, bro? She that liveth in pleasure is dead while she moving.
Huh?
She that liveth in pleasure. Hold up. It might not even be there. Whew. It's 10 of you. I should know better than that.
Is it graduation week out here, I think?
I know it's coming up. But anyway, these niggas is in the spirit of the woman, you know, into that pleasure spirit, into that, you know, that foolish spirit, a foolish spirit, you know? Because that's their motivation. That's the motive behind what they're doing is the black woman. And the black woman like anything and every fucking thing. Anything and everything. The black woman.
Yeah, that's why they got that new Ghostbuster movie that came out with old women.
Ain't seen that commercial.
And everybody say, you know, this shit looks horrible. They're trying to force that feminine vibration on everybody. Yeah.
You seen 10 Clover Lane? Anybody seen that?
Uh-uh.
10 Cloverfield Lane with a dude, Rosie's, you know, the father on Roseanne show.
Oh, Goodman.
Yeah, check
I
it out.
Said John
Goodman. Yeah, 10. He built a bunker, right? This brother built a bunker, right? And he went and saved some people. He didn't have to go save the bitch and this other guy. Well, anyway, as the show goes on, these motherfuckers plotted against Tim to get out the motherfucking bunker. So, you know, eventually both of the men end up dead, but she ends up out in the world courageously driving off in the sunset, going to fight the aliens and shit. You know? But they rise in that bullshit ass body. It is a decent movie till they get to that shit.
Everything got to be about fucking aliens now.
Yeah, right. Everything's headed that way. Everything's headed toward the aliens, looking like something
up. Scoot this back up.
And a woman being masculine and
you know, yeah, the woman's a hero in every new
woman, you know.
Every new movie now, the woman's a hero.
Right. Hold up. This is 1 Timothy 5:6. But she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. Now, you know, walking dead, the walking dead out here, not taking instructions, not planning for destruction, not planning for the Lord, can care less about any warnings.
Well, today's Mother's Day, so.
Oh, damn, I forgot, you're right.
Now today, they're the most exalted creature on the planet on this day. I told my baby's mama today, I told her that she need to pick, you need to pick the boys up today, I ain't got time for that. She's like, oh, happy fucking Mother's Day to me. So I was like, yeah, happy home wrecking hoe day, bitch. Yeah, that's all. She ain't no mother. She's a home wrecking hoe.
Yeah.
She destroyed 2 homes, more homes than that. You don't know how many hoes she wrecked.
So you seriously didn't have the common decency, the sense to know that you went with that shit?
Yeah.
Wow.
Like, fuck your Mother's Day. I'm glad that I ruined it for you.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
You know what I mean?
A mother being with her children is a ruin of her Mother's Day.
The marriage is supposed to be sacred. You know, you get with a woman, you got a family. They ain't never supposed to destroy that. That's sacred. That's just,
mm-hmm.
That's something you're supposed to, until death do us part, bitch. Shit. I was in it for the long haul.
Yeah, right, right. You were sincere.
Yeah.
You know? You don't want no another motherfucker in your pussy?
Hell no, man. That's my the mother of my children. Why right. Why'd I want to leave her?
Right, right, it's, right.
Bitches, that's why the Lord gives us that power. All these hoes, all these home-wrecking hoes, they all going to get put to death. If the missiles don't kill them, the Lord going to give us power. And according to the Bible, we going to kill them.
Oof.
Man, I just think, man, you know what I'm saying? If someone stone that bitch with stones, and after we done stoning her, we're going to burn her. And after we burn her, I'm going to throw off a cliff, and I'm going to take a shit on her.
Well, that's what the power of the Lord gives you power. You're going to do what you will. You're going to do what's lawful. You know? You're going to do what's
yeah,
lawful.
Yeah, that's what's lawful. I mean, I probably take things too far. You know what I mean?
You know, but Most High going to give you power. That lawful power, you're going to be able to chop bitches in pieces. You know? Death, you've been sentenced to death.
Because they don't never ask for forgiveness. I mean, I'm a forgiving person. You know, if a woman asks for forgiveness, she's a hoe. But that bitch, she's too proud. She didn't do nothing wrong.
Right, right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
According to her, she never did nothing wrong in her life.
That's right. Oh, she seems
so there ain't no forgiveness for nobody like that.
Jeremiah 16.
Oh, the defilement? Yeah.
No.
What
you talking about? Jeremiah 16:16. Behold, I will send for many fishes, says the Lord.
Oh, that's a perfect scripture, actually.
Yeah. And they shall fish them. And after will I send for many hunters, and they shall hunt them from every mountain and from every hill and out of the holes of the rocks.
So that hunter is us, the men of Israel, the elect of Israel, actually. So we're going to be hunting. Right now we fishing. Everybody, you all be up in church singing the gospel hymns. Our Lord, make ye fishers of men. You hear that old fishers of men song? I want to hear the hunters of men song.
Oh,
that's the song I want to hear that song. Why can't you know? How come they don't sing songs about hunting?
Right.
They ain't going to sing that one.
We find ourselves a meat one. You know what I mean?
I'm going to go home. I'm going to write that song tonight. It's going to be a heavy metal song. It's going to have the sound of missiles in it.
Oh, that'd be dope. Missiles taking off. The Topol EO missile taking off.
Oh,
the Iskander EO missile. I mean, you ain't going to use no American missiles, are you?
Hell no. That's that bullshit.
The Minuteman.
Even America's missiles is fucking effeminate. You know what I mean?
Right.
Look at the weapons. The Russians got the AK-47. Best weapon ever created. Best rifle ever created. The Americans got the M16, the worst rifle ever created. I mean, get one little speck of dirt in the M16, it was going to misfire. It's a piece of shit.
It misfired.
You pull the trigger, it goes click, it does not fire.
Damn.
That would get you killed shooting that
weapon.
I thought
misfire was when someone was in the barrel.
Well, yeah, that too. Okay. You get rounds stuck in the chamber. It's a piece of garbage.
Mm.
I was in the military. We'd be out there doing training with all you hear was click, 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 click.
Wow.
Everybody should be clicking. They get you killed fucking with a weapon like that.
Here you go.
It's because it was all about money. Because the person that got to make the weapon was the lowest bidder. You know what I mean? But Russians, they'll go kidnap a motherfucker and force him to make the greatest shit ever and not pay him shit.
The baddest shit.
Yeah.
All right, Ryan. This is Jeremiah 51 and 19. The portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the former of all things, and Israel is the rod of his inheritance. The Lord of hosts is his name. Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war.
That's a beautiful scripture.
Thou. That's why I like to say it over and over. Thou. He's saying you. You.
Oh.
Thou. Right. Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. For with thee will I break in pieces. Wait a minute. With thee will I break in pieces the nations. And with thee will I destroy kingdoms. What?
Destroy kingdoms.
You know? What?
So all the kingdoms of the earth, they got to be destroyed for the kingdom of the Most High to come in.
Right.
So, yeah, because the kingdom of Satan is not going to exist side by side with the kingdom of the Most High.
Hell.
Ain't going to be no America.
Far off in the distance and shit.
Yeah.
In its own.
Ain't going to be none of these kingdoms. There's going to be one kingdom. Okay? One rule, one law.
That's right.
One Lord.
He's cracking up. Listen to me. Yeah, that's right. Serving one power under the Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shah. You know, ain't no Jesus. Ain't going to be under no fucking Buddha or no goddamn, you know, some monks up in the mountains and shit doing their own shit. And there definitely ain't gonna be no goddamn Arabs, you know, talking about Allah Wakbar.
Oh, hell no. They all gonna get put to the sword.
Right, right.
If we don't kill them, we enslave them.
It says, and with thee will I destroy kingdoms. So we're gonna destroy kingdoms. We're gonna be together as brothers, 144,000 destroying fucking kingdoms.
That's beautiful.
You know?
And ain't gonna be no multiculturalism. You know what I'm saying? Oh, we got respect the Muslims.
We can live as one.
Yeah, we go.
Live together.
Hell no. You see them faggots over in Europe? Look, London got a Muslim mayor of London.
Yo, that's just got
they done. The Muslims done conquered England. They're a bunch of faggots.
They sure do.
They conquered. Well, we know the so-called Jews behind that anyway.
That just brings to mind that song, The London Bridge.
The London Bridge is falling down?
Yeah. That's Esau's power, man.
Yeah.
That's Esau's power. That's just a sign of... It don't mean shit because a Muslim is in office over there that they come to power. That's just a sign of Esau losing power. The Edomites. Heathens. God damn it.
And the two-thirds going to get fucked up, too.
That's right.
Part of their punishment.
That's right.
Because you got plenty of Jakes over there living in England. And part of their punishment for transgressing the laws of the Heavenly Father is getting ruled over by Muslims.
That's all that's over there.
Yeah, Jake is everywhere. All them
that's
Irishmen.
All that's over there.
The Scotsmen.
Yep. That's it.
Yeah, there's a lot of them over there.
And with thee will I break in pieces the horse and his rider. That can be, you know, motherfuckers in tanks, helicopters, you know.
Yep.
The horse is representing power.
Yep. That's why you got horsepower.
Horsepower, that's right. Horsepower. The chariots is referred to as horses in certain scriptures. And with thee will I break in pieces the horse and his rider. And with thee will I break in pieces the chariot and his rider. With thee also will I break in pieces man and woman. What? Woman?
Woman?
What woman?
Hold up now.
These hoes? A hoe?
That's
why I look for this, because when you're talking about your baby mama.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
They ain't going to get broken in pieces, man.
Get towed the fuck up. Get towed up. You know, you put meat through a green meat grinder, that shit's unrecognizable, man. We don't have that type of power. Whatever we do, these motherfuckers, you ain't gonna know what's actually human. What is that, a dog, or you know?
They gonna be astonished at their plagues. Like yeah. Revelation says, they gonna hiss at it.
Yeah.
And they ain't gonna believe such a punishment was possible.
Look how comfortable they are.
They ain't living good.
The one in Psalms.
Rolling in a Studebaker.
Right.
Is that what that was? That car.
The one in a song somewhere when it says that 10,000 shall flee one, 1,000 shall flee one, whatever. That's another example of the power. With thee also will I break in pieces man and woman. And with thee will I break in pieces old and young. God damn. Old and young. And with thee will I break in pieces the young man and the maid. I will also break in pieces with thee the shepherd and his flock. Pastor Pork Chop, Deacon No Law, you know, Creflo Dollar, you know, Jesse Jackass, Minister Louis Farrakhan.
Oh, light,
right.
What's some other dude?
Sinek and Sinigga.
Shit, Sakari.
Sakari, right, that's shit hand.
Peraza.
Peraza, man. Definitely Peraza.
We did to cut him. Y'all gonna get cut, man.
Cut him, yeah. Get cut the
you gonna fall on, you know what I'm saying, on your own sword.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see what the Lord got coming for them.
Oh, we gonna see it too. We gonna witness it too.
I can't wait.
That's gonna be a gift he gonna give to us. We gonna see that shit. Something, we're like, damn!
The Lord said started his sanctuary first.
Yeah, that's right. And that sounds like motherfuckers that know they're Israelites.
Yep.
You know, that's what it sounds like to me. You know, his sanctuary. Motherfuckers are supposed to be feeding the flock.
Well, really, they just starving the flock. Mm-hmm. Just taking all their money.
Chained them up in a dark room.
Yeah, chained them up.
They left them there.
They added bondage to bondage. What did Paul say? They're adding onto your bonds.
Oof.
I'm gonna look for that.
That's bad. That sounds bad right there. That sounds bad. Right,
because you know, we spoke. They don't know about the liberty in your house. They trying to put you in back in slavery.
That's fucked up. And that was beautiful. Tahar came out with a video and he mentioned how the black woman was a lot of the slave masters. You know, the power she got, she gained some riches and freedom or whatever. So she went and bought other slaves too. You know? That really is so good. That's spiritual, ain't it?
Yeah.
It's just spiritual.
It's a bitch named Tubby. She was a
territory. Yeah, she was. Yeah, she was. It's like, you know, they just doing what they're supposed to do. Baseball, they are, the scriptures does say they are enemy.
Eddie George got shut the fuck down, yeah. I heard they was moving it.
All straight up.
Yeah. That's good. About time.
Right, I hope it. I can't stand it.
He's a big fat.
No, him though. Okay.
Why am I shooting?
Okay. Here we go, and I'm gonna start at the six because this is just meat and six, and it's very relevant to what's going on. This is Micah 7:6. For the son dishonors the father, the daughter rises up against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. The man's enemies are the men of his own house. Therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the for Yahweh of my salvation. My power will hear me. Rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall rise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. I will bear the indignation of the Lord, because I have sinned against him. And that's, he's referring to men. Until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me, not these bitches.
Hell no.
He will bring me forth to the light, and I will and I shall behold his righteousness. Then she that is mine enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her which said unto me. And because these bitches, some shameless bitches right now.
They shameless.
They're shameless like a motherfucker.
Like I said, they would never admit their guilt. They'll never repent for their sins.
For what?
They didn't sin.
They didn't do shit wrong.
Right.
You know?
Like, I'm allowed to fuck whoever I want to fuck.
Right.
It's my pussy, bitch. Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That sounds just like them.
Fucking whores.
Sounds just like them. You don't know how wrong you are, bitches. Hoes.
I hate you.
Now, there's some good girls out there that are sincere, that may mean good. Now, I'm saying may. It might.
It's easier to find Waldo to find one of them hoes.
Right. You know, Solomon was a prime example.
Where's Waldo? Where's the good hoe?
Right. And that's shame. Serious.
I ain't seen one.
I ain't never met one.
I ain't met
never,
one.
Never, man.
I ain't met. I mean, never, never. We keep hearing about them, right, but I ain't seen them.
Yeah, just like hearing about that snapping pussy. I ain't never heard of them. Never seen one. I mean, you know what I mean? For real, man. I'm just trying to keep it real. Real talk.
I ain't seen it.
Real talk.
Maybe one y'all one. Got them over there in the state you live in. They ain't over here.
Right, right. Maybe that's one. I don't know.
I don't see it.
Right. Then she that is mine enemy shall cover it, shall see it, and shame shall cover her which said unto me, where is the Lord thy power? These exact words a bitch said to me. My eye shall behold her, now shall she be trodden down as the mire of the streets.
You're going to get it trodden down just like Jezebel got trodden down. You know what I'm saying?
Get stomped the
get
fuck
get stomped
down.
In the mire, that means in the dirt. You gonna eat dirt.
That's right.
Just like when Jezebel got tossed out the damn window.
Stumped to pieces. And all you saw was a fucking lip or a finger or some shit. Or...
She got, they said that she was eaten by the dogs, and then
the dogs shit her out. Hey, it's coming. And the Lord keeps his promise. It's coming to you wicked hoes. Okay.
And to the Captain Saber hoes, y'all gonna get even worse punishment.
Because they should know better.
Yep.
Because I know, you know them Captain Saber hoes experience wicked ass bitches. You know?
They contribute to these bitches.
Mm-hmm. Little bitches wicked as all hell, and they gonna still wanna support them bitches and call them queens. Queen of the damn, queen of the flies. You know? Queen of the sewer.
Did it have one back then?
What's up, man? Jeremiah 4:30. And when thou art spoiled, what wilt thou do? Though thou clothest thyself with crimson, though thou deckest thee with ornaments of gold, though thou rentest thy face with paintings, in vain shalt thou make thyself fair. Thy lovers will despise thee, they will seek thy life.
Yeah, because... That's what happens to a hoe, is death. Just like O.J. Simpson's wife. That's the whole classic story.
The cop.
She was committing adultery, so he killed her.
The cop.
How many times you heard of a dude just killed a wife and her boyfriend because they cheated on him? It happens all the time. Just like that dude ran on Parsons a couple years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Killed that bitch.
Yeah, she just found new success, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A business owner. Oh, she was just a strong woman. You know, she was a successful business owner. You don't know why he killed her. He's such a... You know, they try to make it look like the man was in the wrong.
She was the demon. She was the devil.
That's a fucked up thing about living in America, too. Your woman can cheat on you, and there's nothing you can do about it. And she, you know, she breaks up your family, leaves you. You know what I'm saying? Makes it so you can't see your children again. And if you go kill her or do something about it, hey, you'll get locked up. But
yeah, there's nothing what happens to you. Behind your righteous act. It's heavy consequences.
So that's how you know we in Satan's kingdom.
That's right.
And there's nothing you can do about it either. You got to deal with it.
Cry to the
Lord. All you got to do is pray to the Most High that he deals with it. And he is going to deal with it.
Sexual bitches right there. Sexual little Edomites.
Ah. The end of America is coming soon. Live it up now.
Yes.
Shit ain't gonna be around too much longer.
That bitch wasn't courageous enough to dodge them bullets.
You know?
I mean, she's the black woman. She's God, right?
She should have superpowers.
Why she didn't stop them bullets right there in the face and turn around?
Catch them with her teeth, like Bruce Leroy.
Right. Black bitch. Little stinking pussy bitch.
Bitches do be stinking too, man.
They stink, yo. You know that foul shit come right out their pores, man. And that alcohol perhaps bring it out. You know they be boozing.
That's all they do. Smoke blunts, pop pills, drink. They drink that bullshit too. They be drinking that Four Loko. That's their favorite drink now is Four Loko.
I still ain't gonna drink that shit.
Hell no. That's some immediate rock gun shit. That shit is not safe.
That's fucking ridiculous. I'm going back to share my opinion.
It is nothing more unattractive. There's nothing more unattractive than a drunk ass bitch too, looking all sloppy.
Cigarette in
the mouth. Oh yeah, cigarette all stinking, all loose and shit. There's some loose ass hoes out here, man.
Polluted hoes.
They just out of fucking order.
Polluted is all fucking hell.
They is polluted.
Let me get them.
They're fucking whores.
You ain't supposed to be fucking these. You know that bitch has been fucking other niggas, man. You ain't supposed to be going in after that bitch, man.
Hell no.
After no man. Here, Jeremiah 3:1.
Sometimes you gotta turn down the pussy. Like, no. You gotta raise your standards.
It ain't even hard no more, is it?
No, hell no.
It's not even hard to walk with the pussy no more, man. Not like before, man.
I play hard to get with these bitches.
Yeah, play a game with them. They play with you, play with them.
Because I already know that I'm more valuable than them.
Right.
You know what I mean? I got way more to offer than them.
You're
ain't got nothing to offer me. What you got to offer me? A stinking asshole?
Right.
That's all you got. What else you got to offer me? Some wisdom, some knowledge?
Right. And that's screams to what you just said.
Ain't got no comfort.
Right. There's more value in something that's less of than something that's more of.
Exactly.
You know? And besides, the Lord made this value. You know? He said we like gold and sapphires and things like that. Remember Jeremiah 3:1. They say, if a man put away his wife and she go from him and become another man, shall he return unto her again? Shall not that land be greatly polluted? But thou hast played the harlot with many lovers. And I bet they don't even know 90% of the names of the motherfuckers she fucked.
You know they don't forgot them.
Yep.
They done forgot it the first night.
Yep.
They're like, damn. And then it's not even a big deal to them.
Right.
Because, you know, to them, a dick gets old. I've had a bitch tell me that before. I had to cut her off because she looked at me one day. She was like, you ain't shit but a dick to me.
Oh.
That's what she told me.
Ooh.
Like, goddamn. That's all I am to you, huh? Just a dick.
You sold kingdom.
the fuck?
Just the dick.
And got surprised when I didn't talk to it no more.
Dick. Just the dick. Because they can go out and shop and get another. They don't care if it's infected or something.
What the fuck?
They don't care if it's from a Chihuahua or a Rottweiler or another, or an Edomite or an Edomite. They don't give a shit. You know? Yeah. But thou hast played the harlot with many lovers, yet return again to me, said the Lord. Lift up thine eyes unto the high places and see where thou hast not seen been blameless. In the ways hast thou sat for them as an Arabian in the wilderness, and thou hast polluted the land with thy whoredoms and with thy wickedness.
Ah, fuck, it is dudes. What was that, a church bus or something? Yeah, it looked like the retard church bus or something. They was dudes.
Men is dead.
Our church is dead.
Don't do your thing.
You can't drop the standard. It's like dropping the flag in battle.
America, lock your ass up. You're dropping the American flag and stomp.
Ain't you watch the movie Glory? They fought to hold that flag up.
That's a good ass movie.
I ain't seen that in years. I'm gonna have to go back and watch it.
Yeah. That's a good ass movie. All-Star cast.
Denzel. That's when I first found out about Denzel.
What?
Yeah, I think that's the first Denzel movie I seen.
When he still had buck teeth.
Oh, he got him fixed, huh?
Yeah. Spent big money and got him done perfect. Take care.
Oh, bullshit Civil War.
Them motherfuckers was fighting. We didn't give a damn about getting their head blown off.
That's some brutal shit too, man.
Right.
Fighting in ranks.
Whew.
That's brutality.
Robert.
Since we talking about them hoes.
Bitches.
Hey, you feeding the birds.
I couldn't do it, man.
Go ahead.
This is second address, 15. And, six. The wickedness have exceedingly polluted their whole earth.
Yeah.
And their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness.
That's right. That speaks for itself.
Which they profanely commit, neither will I suffer them in those things in which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood cry for to me.
That's us.
And the souls of the just complain continually. And therefore saith the Lord, I will surely avenge them and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them.
Well, who else could that be referring to? Who else, you know? Besides the apostles, a great millstone in their fruit, you know? And we part of that fruit because we bring it out 100. And we faithful in this, as far as I'm concerned. Lord can take us out quickly if he wants.
Shit, faithful, we the only ones to teach about faith.
That's right.
Everybody else teach, all they want to teach the law.
People write about the graduation.
What?
See that?
Oh, it is today. I knew it just happened. Maybe it was yesterday. I don't know. I thought it'd be popping out here today.
You probably will be.
You never know what could happen.
Yeah. It's
minute to minute, anything could happen.
So yes, holy shit. Okay. What was he on? What's that scripture? Right? Yeah. Who else is out here? You know, complaining about scripture. This wickedness. Besides, you know, especially in this big ass city, Columbus, man. This is it.
This is it, man.
You know.
I wanted to get this one scripture. Yeah, because when you just talking about Great Millstone, because these other camps. Because usually, you got all these other camps on YouTube, what did they talk about? Every video they talk about is GMS.
Yeah.
Everybody scoffing. They've been scoffers and scorners and assholes. Right.
They call themselves teachers.
They ain't teaching shit. They look retarded. You know what I'm saying? Look like a bunch of fucking jackasses.
Oh, yeah, let me read this now.
What you got?
The definition of folly.
Folly?
Yeah. That's bad. It's bad, too.
Oh, go ahead. this is Philippians. Philippians 1 and 15. Some indeed preach it how it shy, even of envy and strife, and some also of goodwill. So that's most of them dudes out there, you know, who didn't come up under great millstone. They all about envy and strife. Because they envious, they jealous, because the Spirit of the Lord is not dealing with them. So they want to cause all this strife, you know what I'm saying? The one preaches Yahweh Shai of contention, not sincerely. You know what I mean? And they all doing it for vainglory, like it's a battle rap or something. So they want to get they shine. And they can't be wrong, you know. They just a bunch of proud faggots. A bunch of devils.
Black devils.
The one that preaches Yahweh Shai of contention, not sincerely. Then we teach us sincerity, bro. We really believe in this. That's why, you know, we got the spirit of forgiveness on us. The spirit, you know, we know how to work in the spirit.
Hey, we got the spirit of being aligned on us too.
Oh, that too.
If necessary, you know, if necessary. What's up, man?
But one preacher have a shot of contention, not sincerely, supposing to add affliction to my bonds.
That's what you're
saying. You know, that's what scripture
says. That's what you're talking about.
That's what they want to do. They want to, yeah. Paul was locked up, yeah. Right? Yeah. They wanted to make it even worse for him.
Right.
He was already locked up, man. They try to make it worse.
Spirit of a woman, the spirit of Herod taught me.
It's like we out here, we are already in slavery.
Yeah.
And then you want to go trap men in the net again and put them in twofold slavery.
Right. Right.
Oh, trying to control men, they pretty much mind fucking their followers, trying to control every aspect of everything they do.
Yeah.
And the truth is, a lot of people that you see that teaching the claim to be teaching the scriptures, they're a bunch of fucking weirdos, and they're just parrots. They just regurgitating what they was told. They don't even know what they're talking about. They don't know no scriptures. They don't be studying.
That's why when you ask them a question, they keep walking, don't they?
Yeah.
How many videos do we have?
Like Nate's people. Like last 2 weeks.
Right.
We been seeing the IUIC people down there. And them dudes are in bonds, bro. Nathaniel got them dudes in bonds. He got them shackles on their minds.
Right.
He got them in slavery. Because they don't know nothing. They don't know no scriptures. You just see that dead look in their eyes. You ask them a question, and they're like, dude. Dude,
right.
Yeah, they don't have their own minds. They can't think for themselves.
Yeah, they can't battle precept to precept.
Because the truth is like a river is a living water. You got to flow like water.
That's right.
So you come up talk to us, we're going to flow like water. You know what I'm saying? Yes, we ain't no second guessing.
Right. No fear. Nah, it
just comes out.
So you know.
Yeah. Man, go ahead.
Psalms 33 and
Oh, so you talking about the slave masters, my fucking, like Nathaniel's a slave master. You know what I'm saying? He got them people in slavery, man. Got them all wearing uniforms. They're all the same.
That's crazy.
Wearing the exact same clothes.
You know
that's what Esau does in the military.
Right. Yeah.
That means none of them have their own identity. They're like clones. That's the army of the clones. That's the attack of the clones. That's the clone wars. Yeah. They some clones, bro. They you know what I'm saying, like soulless. They don't have, like, you just dead spirits, bro.
Clones, they always got to take orders.
Yeah, they don't question nothing to do that.
This is Psalms 32, 29-8. I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go. I will guide thee with mine eye. Be not as the horse, or as the mule, which have no understanding, whose mouth must be held in with bit and bridle, lest they come near unto thee.
Free that kid, man. Dude, like.
Psalms 32 and 9. Be ye not as the horse, or as the mule.
As the mule, a jackass. Don't be a jackass. And don't be a dumb ass. You got a lot of dumb asses out there. That's what y'all are, dumb asses.
Dumb asses.
I mean, this is, man, when you read some of the comments on YouTube, the people be leaving on the videos, there's some stupid fucking people out there. And you don't even know what to say. you just gotta ignore them after time because you don't know what to say.
Yeah.
I mean, they're so far gone, there's nothing you can say.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, you just fucking retard. And they leave responses this damn long. They write, yeah, we have page long in all caps.
And then I'm pasting from somewhere else. They good at that too.
They gone, man.
Yeah. You got more down?
Whose mouth must be held in with bit and brutal, lest they come near to thee.
Yeah, so this
can be controlled by brutal.
Yep, because.
Ain't that the thing that goes in the horse's mouth?
Yeah.
That you can pull it from left to right.
That's what Nate be doing. Like, come on.
Yeah, yeah. Here you go. This is Ezekiel 22 and 29. The people of the land have used oppression and exercised robbery, you know, and have vexed the poor and needy. Yea, they have oppressed the stranger wrongfully. Read it again. Ezekiel 22 and 29.
Hey, I had to look at that word stranger in that scripture. It's probably talking about an Israelite stranger.
Yeah. Because
you know, if you got Israelites, you know, who look a little different from the rest of the bunch.
Just from
they're quick to throw his ass in slavery. Right, let's get him. Let's get him. A bunch of devils, man.
Yeah. The people of the land have used oppression and exercised robbery. Because they ask for more than the amount of tithes. They require more.
Yeah, then you gotta buy the special uniform.
Yep. Starter kit.
Yeah, you got. Man, these people are evil as hell, man.
Starter kit. And they taxing for that shit, too.
Poverty pimps.
Yeah, poverty pimps, yeah. But Tupac said, I'm gonna drop a dime to God for those that rob the poor or something.
Oh, that's the thing. I remember talking about some. I was just listening to Scarface. I'm guilty of listening to Scarface every once in a while.
Tupac in his prophetic line.
Remember that Scarface, the Mind Playing Tricks Part 2?
Right.
He's like, he was talking about those churches in that song. He's like, they won't give the money. No, he said he'll give money to the most needy. He'll never put it in the hands of the most greedy.
Right.
You know, he was talking about them churches, how them churches, they getting all this money, got a new Benz, while Brother Johnson just got kicked out the place where he lives.
Okay.
Even the devil's right sometimes.
Yeah, right. I mean, come on. Don't be wrong. You gotta know the truth in order to push that madness into
him. Face gotta have been hurt by him. He living too good though, probably. Scarface?
Oh, yeah. He's getting tours and shit. I mean, they ain't asking us to go on tour with us on the team. You know, that shit costs money. That motherfucker ain't going to some city.
He should be charging too.
The money, right?
Didn't you say he was down at Scully's?
He was down at Scully's a couple months ago or something. A month ago, maybe. Shit was packed. Scarface got a huge following.
He way better than the new rappers, though. Yeah. Hey, what's this, let me get this scripture real quick right here.
We could ask Israelites, man.
I got a scripture for all these, actually, I'm just going to read all of this, man. Because this is really goes in on these wicked devils out here. That they're out here trying to catch men up in their cults. Psalms 10 and 1. Why standest thou afar off, O Lord? Why howdest thou thyself in times of trouble? The wicked in his pride doth persecute the poor, letting them be taken into devices that they have imagined. For the wicked boasteth of his heart's desire, and blessed the covetous whom the Lord abhorreth. Oh yeah, I was watching this clown's video. You know how everybody was getting on killing priests? And you got people taking up for killer priests. Well, y'all just mad because, you know what I'm saying, he got money and he was successful. But when in the meantime, killer priest is talking, teaching the Anunnaki and shit, saying that mankind was created by aliens. Some bugged out shit, man.
Yeah, I was watching some of that shit, bugging out.
But he got what he had covered, man. He thought he was going to slither around and nobody's going to call him out on this shit.
That's what it was. That's what it was.
He thought he was protected or something. He thought the Lord was with him. For the wicked boasted of his heart's desire, and blessed of the covetous whom the Lord abhors. That's what all the haters of Great Millstone do too, don't they? Don't they always bless the covetous? You know what I'm saying? They'll take up for Nate, but like, well, he's doing good for the community. You know what I'm saying? Building up. You know what I'm saying? He got an economical program.
Economical?
Because they're more into this world. They care more about the riches of this world than the riches of the Heavenly Father.
Yep.
The wicked, through the pride of his countenance, will not seek after the Most High. The Most High is not in all his thoughts. His ways are always grievous. Thy judgments are far above out of his sight. As for all of enemies, he puffeted them. He has said in his heart, I shall not be moved, for I shall never be in adversity.
This bitch was like bugging out. She was like, doing some spirit. I'm sorry.
Bro. That's some demons, spirit, bro.
Yeah,
the
right,
spirit.
Right. I saw what you're talking about.
They probably just got done smoking a blunt, bugging out.
Sniffing something.
Yeah, sniffing some shit.
Right.
But there you go, that's some dudes again. He said in his heart, I shall not be moved, for I shall never be in adversity. Like Killer Priest. He thought he wasn't going to see no adversity.
Right.
You know, he thought he was good. Just like a lot of these Israelite groups out here, they think that, you know, that they untouchable. The Lord ain't going to deal with them. They just going to slip through the cracks.
Right. They're putting them days of trouble for us.
Yeah, they put, yeah.
They can't honestly relate to what happened soon, you know? It's something that either they don't think is going to happen or it's going to happen far off.
Because they just know what the tomorrow brings, right. You know?
Faithful is more focused. Faithful is all here. You still got more than that?
Yeah, I got just a little more. It said, his mouth is full of cursing and deceit and fraud. Because most of these cats, they just fraud. They just looking to rip you off and to get money. Like all these most so-called teachers out here in the world, whether they be claiming they an Israelite or they teaching Egypt or they into the New Age shit or reptilians or all these crazy different philosophies, it all boils down to money. They just trying to defraud you out your money, basically.
That's the root, that money.
Their money's root of all evil.
That's their foundation.
The love of money, yeah.
That's their foundation.
Yep.
You know, money.
All right, here goes more too right here. He sitteth in the lurking places of the villages, in the secret places doth he murder the innocent. His eyes are privily set against the poor. He lieth in wait secretly as a lion in his den. He lieth in wait to catch the poor. He doth catch the poor when he draweth him into his net.
Like a bird circling.
Yep.
Way up there, but the eyes be zooming in on the damaged or hurt animal that eventually he's gonna shoot down on the bowels. And that's what these people, they're in the spirit of a vulture, you know?
I mean, that's the point right there.
They're in the spirit of a vulture, looking to take advantage of the weak and needy, you know?
That's the easiest ones to get.
Yep. You know? And that's men that I'm referring to. Women is just naturally in there.
Because they take advantage of brothers' ignorance, too, because, you know, they come straight out the streets, you don't know nothing. You never heard no scripture before in your life, but they'll come up on them. And they'll give them this bullshit doctrine. Then they'll have them brainwashed and have them believe in some bullshit. And then they got them.
That's crazy. Because them motherfuckers ain't nothing to everybody.
Yeah, because really, if you get tricked by them, you deserve it.
Yeah, right.
Really. Because you ain't never. You ain't going to see me following no people like that.
This is 1 Timothy 6 and 9. But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. For the love of money is the root of all evil,
yep.
Which while some coveted after, they have erred through the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. I mean, like an individual like that wicked ass nigga Michael Jordan, you know he ain't sleeping good, man.
Hell no.
You know? All them demons he's sleeping with, laying with. Motherfuckers like Beyonce and Jay, they ain't sleeping too good now. Because the Most High Spirit is coming amongst the earth, coming upon this new planet, man. And it's affecting everybody. This was here. You see how everybody's acting crazy now, man, doing stupid shit.
Yeah.
Committing suicide, militaries, motherfuckers blowing their heads off left and right at a record level. Bankers is jumping off a building's hand first and blowing their hands off. This shit is getting worse and worse and worse, man. Police is turning in their own police. Everybody's turning against everybody. Just like the Lord said. He's bringing division, man.
He And the Lord came to bring division, not
That's
peace.
That's right. Can you imagine what these motherfuckers been doing this wickedness for so long? How they look at each other, man. They can't look at each other in faith and trust and true brotherhood, man. They looking on that motherfucker. I think something's in his mind. He's thinking about turning against us or something. Just in their head. Just something doing evil with somebody. That evil seed is in your head. It's already planted. Can't trust the motherfucker.
Hell no. You know? A lot of them dudes ain't right. You see the weird spirit. They got weird, strange spirits on them.
Weird. Creepy.
Like a dude that was down with Peraza up in that cutting video. Y'all, whoever watching this, they got that bugged out rap video. They all rapping, but we met that dude that was rapping in there. He came up and talked to us one day. We was trying to be cool with him and everything, you know.
Yeah, we was cool with him.
You know, we ain't.
We was trying to be brother, you know.
But he kind of had a weird, strange spirit on him.
You know?
You know, a strange spirit that, you know, that is not known to us.
You couldn't relate to him.
That dude was off, bro.
Came up here like a snake told while he was just riding by. That was plain.
Wow, it's dead. I don't believe in coincidences.
Yeah.
Matthew 23:4. For they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be bare, and lay them on men's shoulders, but they themselves will not move them with one of their fingers.
Wow.
Yeah, that's what them dudes, they always, and you know, they worship the law more than they worship the Lord. And then they don't even keep the law themselves. Oh, you know, a wicked and adulterous generation. That's what these fools are.
What are you calling them?
Hell no.
That's a spirit.
Yeah. All right.
Good one up. All there, verse 3. All therefore, whosoever they... I mean, all therefore... Whatsoever they bind, bid you observe, that observe and do. But do not ye after their works, for they say and do not.
Right.
Keep on.
Right.
For they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be borne, and lay them on man's shoulders, but they themselves will not move them with one of their fingers.
Right, because they teaching the gospel of contention and strife. They ain't teaching in truth and sincerity, you know. Yep, looking to really care about brothers, and, you know, we trying to get in the spirit of brothers and forgive brothers of the transgressions and all.
Right, because Nate don't even go to the streets anyway. He got his men going to the streets.
You don't never hear that word faith. They make mockery of faith. They say they call us faith-based Israelites.
Faith-based Israelites.
All right. We got great faith that you're going to be destroyed. Now keep going with that. We're going to read all of that.
All their works they do for to be seen of men.
Yeah, to be seen. The only reason half these people are out here teaching the Bible is so they can be seen of men. They want to get some glory. Especially that Sakari dude. The Sakari sect. That's all he cares about is to be seen of men. This guy thinks he's a superstar. Got videos of him up in the studio rapping about bitches drinking his sperm. You a nasty motherfucker, man. That's some shit you should have left in the world. You still in the world. He got a punk ass with long ass hair looking like a woman. Come on, man. Get out of here. Oh, he had took the vow of a Nazarite.
So on the Passover, he don't drink wine? So he don't do the Passover then?
Shit. Man, that's just that bullshit. Bullshit excuses so he can keep some long hair.
Vain shit, yeah. The scripture says it's a shameful man.
I mean, that's on you, though. I mean, if you want to have a woman's hair, I mean, look like a woman, bro.
He got a foul spirit on him. He seems like a person. He ain't cool, man.
He always trying to sound all intelligent, trying to talk over.
That's how pimps sound.
Yeah.
That's how pimps
you
sound.
You ain't fooling me, man.
Hustle.
You might.
Those are Jakes.
Oh, yeah.
Those are Jakes.
Yeah, dude try to sound all official and shit. He sounds
official,
like...
Official, right?
Ain't nothing official about you, bro.
Official. I ain't used that word in a long time.
You know, he thinks he's really up there, man. He's really thinking he's a great man, a great stature. Oh, keep going with that, man. Keep going with that. Hold up. Be right before you get that. Well, go ahead and read it. I'm going to find it.
Motherfucker's just a baby in this shit. It's true.
Baby, he's not even in the truth.
Right. Oh, correction.
He said you don't worship your Hawashai.
Far from the... Yeah.
That's an antichrist.
Yeah.
He's the devil.
Yeah.
They make broad their polyesters.
Just like everybody else, his whole doctrine evolves around trying to disprove Great Millstone Run. And what's a hell of a doctrine you got there? So,
this idiot, bro. This, it was a live show. The dude was like,
you can watch the episodes? No. Go ahead.
It was like, they were saying that having an image of how shy is it's like an idol. But it's, he got, it's, you know, YouTube has a little picture in the background.
Yeah.
It's a picture of how shy, so he's a fucking hypocrite.
He's a hypocrite.
He said you can't use it because it's an idol.
The idol. And then he got a 6-point star with wings on it. I mean, that's an idol. That's an image. And you're using that like, oh, look at us. We big, super badass motherfuckers. We got.
That's bad. Man.
Yeah,
that's beautiful, man.
You're a joke,
that's
beautiful, man.
That's really beautiful, man. Because it's putting them out on blast, that scripture, man. It's putting them out on blast.
And then they always want to get on the elder apostle or car.
They can't get them no fucking.
Man, get the fuck out of here. Don't nobody even care, bro.
Right. Right. That's envy and jealousy.
That's envy and jealousy.
That's envy and jealousy.
You know what I'm saying? Because our brother obviously coming out right. with some spiritual right. truth.
That's a great man.
Yeah.
That's a great man.
He get in the spirit. He'll break some shit down. He sees things that you don't. And that, you know, everybody got sins too, bro. Ain't nobody perfect. See, these motherfuckers don't know shit, man. Appalachian.
And he's the first one to leave the mountains.
He's like, mama, I did it.
That's funny, man.
Well, I bet she
probably fucked with that.
Oh, yeah, you know, you shit. You know, yeah, Dan, his mom's probably his aunt.
Yep. Them ain't city folks. You can see that.
Yep.
They want some. They probably some Mormons and shit living in the mountains. Everybody go to that sign and take a picture, man, with their graduation shoot. Man. These people are stuck in stupid, man. They stuck on stupid, man.
I got a scripture for Sakari and all them other clowns. This is John 8:23. And he said unto them, ye are from beneath. I am from above. Ye are of this world. I am not of this world.
This world.
And I said therefore unto you that ye shall die in your sins. For if ye believe not that I am he, ye shall die in your sins.
He said you don't worship Yahushua.
He said he don't believe that he is
yeah.
he.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's bad right there.
Boy.
This motherfucker made a video on it too.
He was stood firm in that bullshit he was teaching.
Yeah, that's amazing, man.
He stood stiffly for the works of Satan.
Yeah.
We're going to read the rest of 23. We're going to read all of that.
I got some meat too.
Okay,
evil men, evil men. That's one of the things we're crying about, trying to the Heavenly Father about evil men. The workers of iniquity. The evil workers of iniquity.
It's verse 5. And enlarge the borders of the garments and love the uppermost parts rooms at feast.
Oh, yeah, that's Nathaniel and all them dudes. They always got had the nicest, freshest garments.
Ironed and all.
They got, they be, yeah, you know, they iron for like an hour before they go out teaching.
That's the start spray.
Yeah, they got the start. They put the creases in their pants and all that.
Right, they put his shit in the cleaners, though.
They probably going out, they got their J's on. Oh, yeah, they go to the cleaners.
They take their shit to the cleaners.
Oh, shit.
You know, they make money. You know?
Now have Mama-san up in there working it out.
Right, right. They do be hooking shit up, though.
They do, bro.
I used to do that all the back in the day. I used to do that all the time.
I used to take shit serious.
Yeah, yeah.
My creases, I did my own shit. I had skills, bro.
Right.
I get the creases. It should be so fine.
Cut them, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Right, right. Yeah, that's in their mind, though. They worry about how to think.
They weren't worried about appearances. Themselves. Yeah. Then they be quick. Oh, you don't wear fringes while you at work. I wear fringes. That means I'm holier than now. So they missed the whole point. They missed the whole damn point. They thought the fringes was the Lord and Savior.
The precepts of men,
man. Yeah, precepts of men. People are fucking whacked in the head,
right,
man.
Right, right.
But fucking whacked.
Yeah. And the medication that we prescribe for them is called an ICBM.
Yeah, that will cure that mental illness. Yeah,
right, right, right. It's shaped like a pill, ain't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Pretty much down here. Is that a jank?
Hell yeah. See, got probably done getting
2018, dead. Class of 2018. Missiles should be hitting way before then, hopefully. You know?
No, but women graduate, shit. You got one dude graduate. And we probably just seen him.
Woo! One dude.
And it ain't dumb as hell. Let's not get off track. Go ahead, get that.
Verse 7. Matthew 23:7. And greetings in the markets, and to be called of men, rabbi, rabbi.
Oh, but, yeah. Well, hey, that's a cut on them fake Jews over there. They like to be called rabbi. They like to be called, well, you know, even Jake, though, Jake loved them flattering titles, you know? He liked flattering titles. He, you know, like Nathaniel liked to be exalted. He sits up higher than everybody else so he can look down to him.
Right.
You know, they come up, they want everybody to salute him and do this crazy fucking 10-minute long salute and dress him in certain ways. Fuck all that dumb shit, man. The Lord ain't dealing with that. But the Lord ain't dealing with your vain repetitions and flattering titles.
Right, right.
Go ahead.
But be not ye called rabbi, for one is your master, even Mashiach. And all ye are brethren.
Some just tell me in the spirit, man. There's a lot going on.
Yeah.
A lot of incest, man.
That's what your boy, Pastor David Manning said. He said, boy, that spirit of incest is strong out there.
That's creepy, ain't it? That's some creepy shit.
It's all quiet. Like,
it is creepy,
shouldn't
man.
Be happy. Like, yeah.
Exuberant out here. It's just grinding.
They was happy. They was happy.
Dad should be walking around stumbling and shit.
They was happy when they was down there.
He made it to the promised land.
Fuck. You got a piece of paper. That piece of paper costed you thousands of dollars.
Thousands.
Fucking for a piece of paper?
It ain't no jobs to pay for.
I got a printer at my house.
You can do the same shit. You know what? I'm gonna do that. Print up some paper.
We're gonna make our own diploma. I'm gonna put it on my wall.
Right. This is crazy, man.
Bible school.
Folly. Setting great dignity, just like scripture read.
I wonder what that word diploma means. I'm gonna look that up. Go ahead.
That's interesting. You're right.
Just for the shit to get.
Well, something's in there.
I'm gonna look.
People breaking their necks and destroying their lives, get them.
I'm gonna look it up before I forget.
I can imagine having a $60,000 debt, man. And they have to pay that shit. You can't file bankruptcy and get it right, man. Look how thick that thing is. Whew. God. That's an ass for you, boy. What the fuck do you want a black woman who's an ass like that around here? She healthy too.
Just real quick, diploma.
Damn.
Oh, it comes from the Latin word. I can read the whole thing. We don't need to. It comes from the Greek, which die means two, but it just means folded paper. When you break it, die means two, and ploma means paper.
Right.
So it means folded paper. That's it, bro.
40, 50,
I mean,
60,
you got the definition, but it says, the definition says what you think it would. I ain't got to read all that. It's a waste of time. I'd rather just get straight to the etymology. Folded piece of paper. Shit, and their paper ain't even folded, though.
Can't beat that.
You know what else they be saying? Wearing dresses, but they be wearing gowns. I bet you that shit like a garment.
That goes back from that ancient priestly shit too, though, because that's the priest of Baal type
black
shit.
Too.
Yeah, that goes back to Baal worship. That's why they wear the square hats, the tassels, because the square that goes back to the cube worship of Saturn, all that Baal shit.
Okay, let's get back on the wicked-ass niggas.
All right.
Isaiah 3:4.
They thought we forgot.
Yeah, right. No. For behold, the Lord of hosts, doth take away from Jerusalem and from Judah the stay and the staff, the whole stay of bread and the whole stay of water, the mighty man and the man of war, the judge and the prophet, and the prudent and the ancient, the captain of 50 and the honorable man, and the counselor, and the cunning artificer, and the eloquent orator. Now the Lord just said he's gonna take away from all this out of Jerusalem. Smooth talking niggas, you know.
That's the worst ones you gotta watch out for. They want to sound all smooth, y'all, them smooth speeches. They want their speech to sound attractive and alluring.
Trying to impress the bitch.
Yeah, I ain't trying to impress no bitch. We on a mission. We doing
the. You'll be fighting to impress us, man, when the time comes.
Yeah, exactly. We doing the work of the Lord.
Right.
And the work of the Lord has got nothing to do with a dumbass bitch. And we gonna let them know that they're not welcome.
That's right.
Yeah, well, okay, you can keep your money. I don't need it. You're gonna get burned up anyway.
Yeah, we used to come out here with the offering buckets.
Yeah, nobody gives you nothing, so why even bother?
Does that thing even exist anymore?
Yeah, well, it's somewhere.
Right.
That's just too much shit to carry around.
Right. Ain't nobody putting nothing in anyway.
Hell no. Now, if you teach the truth, you ain't gonna get no money.
Hell no. Crazy shit. This is Ecclesiastes 23:15. Hold up. Okay, 15. The man that is accustomed to opprobrious words will never be reformed all the days of his life. Two sorts of men multiply sin, and the third will bring wrath. A hot mind is as a burning fire. Nigga always just constantly talking shit.
Sicari.
Being the spirit talking shit too, ain't making no goddamn sense.
You watch the Sicari videos too, boy, his eyes are always red. Like you can see the demon in him.
Yeah, yeah. That's why I say wear glasses, to be honest with you.
Like, that's how my little sister was. She got the spirit of Satan in her, bro. She's like always going nuts, busting windows out, starting fights. And you go all of her pictures, she always had red eyes. You knew she was Satan.
That's on sodomite.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that is, oh, we seen that thing.
He's in the bike.
Fucking weirdos, man.
A hot mind is as a burning fire. It will never be quenched till it be consumed.
That's your boy gonna get consumed by those missiles. Sakari gonna get consumed by the missiles.
Yeah.
And then everybody who took up for him on the comment boards and everything and made videos supporting him,
yeah,
you gonna share his same fate.
Yeah. And he ain't making it.
Hell no, he ain't making it.
Ain't no repentance in
him. Nah, ain't no repentance in him. He blasphemed the Holy Spirit. He said, you ain't got to follow your house shot. He said, your house shot doesn't regulate his blood. Boy, once you say that, you denied him, you denied the Father.
Ain't no coming back from that.
Hell no.
A fornicator in the body of his flesh would never cease till he have kindled a fire. All bread is sweet to a whoremonger.
He's a whoremonger. He's rapping about bitches drinking his load and shit. While he's supposedly the head of the church. That's whacked out, man.
He would not leave off till he died. A man that breaketh wedlock saying thus in his heart, who seeth me? I am compassed about with darkness. The walls cover me and nobody seeth me. What need I to fear? The Most High would not remember my sins.
That's the biggest.
She was laid back, bro. She's close to.
Man, you right here, Jay.
Yeah,
she is.
That's
a
big mama. Look at her laugh.
Oh shit, she just got done eating some collard greens and fried chicken.
There ain't no precepts on over here that they taught you. The Most High, he said, the Most High will not remember my sins.
She does, she look like the spokeswoman for Glory Collard Greens.
Yeah.
She on the can smiling.
Right. Oh shit, I think she wanted to come over here, but the dude didn't.
Oh, who knows, I could be making fun of her, but nah, hell no, I don't take it back.
Right. Such a man only feareth the eyes of men.
Oh, that's most people. You know, most people out there claiming to be teachers, that they're more worried about what men think.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So. They want to look cool. They want to. That's why they always want to say the right words. And so we fear the Most High.
That mental was fine. I take claim down. Hey. Chill. Your body's just awesome. literally ran
away.
Language effects speaking. That might be from Nepal, maybe? I don't know. That don't look like Hindu, though.
They don't, but they probably from Nepal.
And they keep shipping in so many new types of heathens up in here.
Ghettos around Dubai. I seen a documentary, man. That shit was bad. And it was all Jake's. Poor
Jake's. In Dubai?
The ghettos, the suburbs. I was tripping, man.
Hey, Dubai is bugged out. That up in the middle of the desert is a super rich ass city.
Super, yeah.
Shit, they all gonna die of fucking dehydration one day. This shit gets shut off.
Whatever disease.
Yeah. Hey, they begin, that's some weird ass, like, the what's that, SARS virus came from the Middle East? Them Arabs are some filthy heathens, man. They got some strange viruses growing over there up in the hot sands of the desert.
That's interesting what's coming up with the Olympics. That Zika is over there in Brazil, big time.
People love the Olympics, too.
Yeah, they getting fired up for it, too. They getting fired up for the Olympics.
You know, it was Adolf Hitler that brought back the Olympics. So that means, I guess, all these people they're all Nazis. Because you tell them that, you know, I'm like, Adolf Hitler brought the Olympics back. They don't even know that.
Such a man only fears the eyes of men, and knoweth not that the eyes of the Lord are 10,000 times brighter than the sun, beholding all the ways of men and considering the most secret.
That bitch running like a gazelle.
It's fucking sissy.
The
fact that nigga just says something else.
I don't care. Fucking ginger. Fucking retard. He over there getting brave. He's about to come over here.
What am I talking about?
Fags are the worst scoffers, too. Yeah. Transsexuals are the worst scoffers, man. They are the disgusting. They'll come over here and get all up in your face, ready to fight you.
They think because they got found some new freedom and shit to be a freak. They think that shit gonna transcend into them being able to beat your ass or some shit.
That's what all these, like, even like all these churches now, they done threw the Bible out the window, and now everything is all about accepting faggots and being a faggot, being a transsexual. And that takes precedent over everything else. Shit is crazy as hell.
Crazy as hell.
It's
Iraq
27 and 28. Mockery and reproach are from the proud, but vengeance as a lion shall lie in wait for them. They that rejoice at the fall of the righteous shall be taken in the snare, and anguish shall consume them before they die. Malice and wrath, even these are abominations, and a sinful man shall have them both.
Malice and wrath.
That's all them scoffers are sworn to come with.
That's how they feel.
It's malice and wrath. Yep. They got some vicious words, too.
Let me look up that.
Malice. Well, malice comes from the Latin mal. It just means evil. That's where you get, you know, malice, malicious, malevolent. There's way more word I can't think right now. Yes, Latin, it means evil or bad.
Let's fake it. His name,
Alizé.
He's calling the prophets like old ass niggas, but the scripture says, wax old in thy work. So that's pointless to scoffing something. Scoffing at somebody because they're old in the truth. That's a good thing.
That's a fool.
Stupid as hell.
That's a fool's
comment.
He's
so stupid he don't even realize what he be saying.
Yeah, that's a fool's comment. He have lack of understanding.
He got no understanding.
Yeah.
He's evil.
Yeah.
He got nothing. All he got is mischievous madness. He got the evil spirit of Loki upon him. Actually, not Loki got more truth than him. Shit. What am I talking about? This dude's lower than a cockroach.
Yes, sir. That's right. That's right.
You know what I'm saying? He's like that bed bug that'd be on your mattress. You know what I'm saying?
Here you go. This is Ecclesiastes 8:16. Strive not with an angry man, and go not with him into solitary places. For blood is as nothing in his sight, and where there is no help, he will overthrow thee.
So, yeah, you don't want to be hanging out with no people like that. Is that they got secret intentions for your ass. Because they only an Israelite when the camera's on. You know what I'm saying? Don't even pay attention. They want attention. It wants attention.
That's what it is.
When you ignore it, it goes away.
Consult not with a fool, for he cannot be counseled.
Yeah, so yeah, you can't take counsel with these fools. They got nothing to counsel you. They got no wisdom to comfort you. There's nothing they can teach you. Actually, there's something they can teach you. They can teach you not how to act. That's how you're not supposed to be. It's always good. I always say it's good to learn from other people's mistakes. You know?
It's Proverbs 9 or 10 and 23. It is a sport to a fool to do mischief, but a man of understanding have wisdom.
Yeah, like mischief. Yeah, your boy Alize always mischievous. He's like the private eye detective going searching for Facebook pages, and he's just wicked, bro. He's just trying to dig up dirt and fucking.
That's his works.
That's what Shay Esau would do. I ain't got time for all that bullshit. Yeah, you know, he be watching every last Great Millstone video, too, just waiting for them to slip up. Like, I know they gonna say something. I'm gonna get them. That's all he's thinking. And just spending, you know, just up to all late night just thinking about how he gonna catch someone slipping. That's a totally wrong way to be going about things. You supposed to be staying up late night wondering how you gonna wake some brothers up. That's a heathen fool, bro.
Well, this is scripture fits perfect for Ecclesiastes 14 and 10. A wicked eye envieth his bread, and he is a niggard at his table. Well, that's all. This is envy.
He's a niggard.
Yeah.
And what's the other one? The testimonies of his niggardness shall not be doubted of?
That's Ecclesiastes.
Was that 24, maybe? It's been a minute since I just read that the other day to somebody. I got you. Oh, it's 31. 31 and 24. Oh, I got 24 right.
31. Oh, there, that's right. But against him that is a nigger, of his meat the whole city shall murmur, and the testimonies of his niggerness shall not be doubted of.
That's your boy Sakari.
He made videos. You know,
yeah.
That's his testimony.
That's your testimony. He testified.
Right.
then the scripture says that when they took Yahshua shot, that they did out of jealousy.
Yep.
Or something like that.
Yep.
Of course. So he's jealous even of Yahshua shot.
Yeah. Witness his miracles. That's crazy.
But the Lord's just a regular man. You know, you ain't supposed to worship him. He only raised the dead, walked on water, got beamed up into a UFO.
Fed thousands and thousands.
Yeah, just,
out of a basket.
Yeah. That's just a regular dude.
You know.
Yeah. Hey, didn't he say, follow me and you shall make you fishers of men? Oh, hold up. Let me get a scripture. You read this to him, he just bug out. Because he denied the scriptures.
He has no understanding.
John 1 and 1. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was God. And the Word... Shalaka, let me read that again. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not made anything that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehendeth it not. That says, and what did the Lord say in John 14, 6? He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. That dude cuts himself, man.
Right. John 1 and 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was the Most High.
That's what I just read.
Did you just read it?
Yeah, read it again. The Lord wanted to come out again. Yeah.
I'm tripping. Once wanted to come out again, right.
Yep.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with the Most High.
See, that scripture right there bugged people out, too. No, they read that and they get all bugged out.
That's where I thought you called something else.
Hey, that's good though. Read it again. It needs to be read again.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with the Most High, and the Word was the Most High. The same was in the beginning with the Most High. But let me find this
out. So the Lord goes way back to the beginning. Something you can't even comprehend. That's part of those mysteries.
John 17:22. And the glory which thou gavest me, I have given them. And the glory which thou givest me, I have given them, that they may be one, even as we are one. The Lord gave outside all his glory. Then he said that all things are given unto me.
He said that, bro. He don't understand that. Why do they call him the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Did it say every knee shall bow? Hold up. That's enough. What was that, that film all day? No, the Philippians. I should know where that's at. I just read that.
Knees to bow reverence.
They said, in the name of Yahweh Shai, every knee shall bow. But that doesn't mean worship. Mine explodes. Yeah, he gone. Your boy gone, man.
Colossians 1 and 16. For by him were all things created.
But,
let me read again. For by him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. I mean, he's going into demons and spirits and apparitions. All things were created by him and for him, and he is before all things, and by him all things consist.
So it was created by him and for him, right? So that means even though it was created for him, we're not supposed to worship it.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
That's just retarded. You do Sakari is retarded. He's a retard. Mm-hmm. He's a reprobate. He's an antichrist. He's an antichrist. I mean, he might as well go link up and go join the synagogue. Go hang out with Esau and study the Kabbalah. You know what I'm saying?
Rabbi Feinstein.
He looked like he a sorcerer anyway, bro.
Rabbi Frankenstein.
He looked like a hood sorcerer. He be doing ghetto sorcery up in the hood with his hood rat bitches. You know, behind closed doors.
Look Esau.
What's up, Esau?
Is that supposed to be funny or something?
He's being cool.
You know,
he's
Esau?
He's being cool.
Look in the mirror, bro. That's you.
He's being cool. He's being cool for his buddy.
He's like, I know who Esau is. And his dad was like, Jacob and Esau.
Sign language or something.
Fucking nerds.
Catch his ass and
howl
and whoop his ass. He will never look that way again, man. You know?
Fucking weirdos.
Whoop his ass. And you can whoop his little ass. Take a belt and just whoop his ass, man. And he can cry like a bitch. Most guy is with these people, man. He wants these people, man. He wants them. Wicked ass son of a bitches. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist.
By him all things consist.
And he is the head of the body.
Oh.
The church.
Oh.
Who is the beginning.
Cut him. He's like, nah. I'm surprised your boy Sakari ain't trying to get in on the cut.
Oh, they don't edit that shit up in their videos, man.
They gonna play up in the videos.
Oh, shit.
But I can rap better than all them dudes, bro. And none of y'all can actually, because I retired from the rap game, son. I go flow better than all y'all. Sakari, you got no skills, son. I laid that in the red. That shit's foolishness, man. They're rapping. Fuck all that shit.
Ain't no time for that.
Hell no. I can't ask too many words and shit, bro.
Ain't no time for
that. Words. I'd rather just play my little guitar solos. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence? For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell, and having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven. And you that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now have he reconciled in the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unprovable in his sight.
So he goes through all that to, you know what I'm saying, sacrifice, you know what I'm saying, because he's presenting us what it's sort of called a propitiatory for our sins. What's that one scripture? I don't know if I can even spell that word. He go through all that for your dumb ass, and but you ain't supposed to worship him, right? Fuck out of here, man. That's blasphemy. You a heretic, Sakari. You an Alizé. You a heretic, bro.
A heretic.
Go ahead.
John 20 and 28. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord and my God. Yahushua saith unto them, him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast. Wait a minute. Did I miss me?
Go ahead.
My Lord and my God, Yahushua saith unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed, blessed are they